presence. I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves, where my heart becomes free and my chains are undone. In your presence, sweetest of loves, where my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. In your presence, Lord, Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and Let your kingdom come among us. Let your glory show your goodness. Here on earth, God, as in heaven, there is power in your presence. Let your kingdom come.
Let your kingdom come.
your kingdom come.
Hello, welcome to Tapestry Vineyard Church. I'm Sherry, I'm the lead pastor of Tapestry. I want to invite you to pray with us this morning. Holy Spirit, we invite you to come. Teach us, lead us, guide us, comfort us, as only you can do. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen. If you would, turn with me in your Bible or on your device to Ecclesiastes 4, verses 9 through 10. Two people are better off than one, for they can help each other succeed. If one person falls, the other can reach out and help. You hear this read a lot at weddings. It's a Bible-y way to say the happy twosome is going to have a better life because they found their pick-me-up person. And now when they inevitably topple emotionally or otherwise, their person will pick them up. It's a good metaphor also for friends and community. In life, we take turns at this pain, this sorrow thing. If it's your turn to experience pain, then everyone else comes around you with love and comfort and picks you up. I love the sentiment, but right now a bucket of sadness has been dumped on everyone. 2020 has been a year of sorrow upon sorrow. The global pandemic has caused so much loss. People have lost health, their jobs, income, they've lost friendships, the opportunity for weddings and graduations and celebrations. They're stuck at home without the typical entertainment. For some, their ability to pay for housing or to buy food, it's just been tragic. Some have experienced miscarriages alone in the hospital room with no husband or friends to comfort them. There have been births with no family, and deaths with no funerals. And I'm sorry if someone you love has died from COVID-19 and you've had to bear the pain on your own. It's traumatic, and honestly, it just sucks. For most of us, this is so different to experience pain at the same time that our pick-me-up person is experiencing pain. The pain undulates differently through each person, toppling us into fight, flight, or freeze mode. Freeze people, are you okay? I wonder if quarantine feels like hiding under the covers. I miss you. I'm praying for you. I'd love to hear from you. Flight people, I see you posting about your garden, your new kitten, and the hot dish you took to your neighbor. I'm guessing it feels too painful to talk about racial tensions and death, so you run to a space that maybe isn't too affected, or sometimes I see you even denying that any of this even really exists. Fight people, you're throwing punches left and right. There's blood dripping from your nose. Your pace is dizzying, but you keep fighting. If you win, you think that maybe it proves you really do have some control over the pain. But here's the thing. We're all unique in our responses to pain, and it's easiest to either avoid each other or to be angry and attack. I sit back and I wonder, how is it that any of us will get picked up after this fall? Even without pain and sorrow, it's a miracle that any of us find our pick-me-up people. We are too often hell-bent on winning the argument at the expense of the relationship. It reminds me of the disciples that followed Jesus. Amongst them, a tax collector, a violent nationalist, rugged fisherman, an educated zealot, a pessimist, a man of royal blood. You know what? If they had met outside of Jesus, they would have been enemies. Craziness of all craziness, Jesus chose these very different people to be on the same team, his team. The bizarre thing was, When each of them streamlined their focus on Jesus, they were able to change the world. When disciples fix their eyes on Jesus, their existence becomes more powerful than just getting along. To keep our eyes on Jesus, we go through the really painful process of removing bitterness, fear, and hate. In our most beautiful state, we clothe ourselves with love, which binds us all together in perfect harmony, according to Colossians 3:14. This is so much bigger than ourselves. We do this so the kingdom of God can break through right here on earth. Jesus didn't want this in a wishy-washy, toothy smile, televangelist sort of way. He didn't beg or bribe people to love. In fact, Jesus said, "I'm giving you a new commandment." Do you hear that? He gave a commandment. He said, "This is an order. It's not optional. I'm giving you a new commandment. Love each other just as I have loved you. You should love each other." John 13:34. I believe that for us, in shouting a resounding yes to Jesus' command, a desperation for love overcomes us. It propels us to care. It is defiant in the face of fight, flight, or freeze because we steadfastly look to Jesus. Remember our verse, Ecclesiastes 4:9-10. Two people are better than one because they can reap more benefit from their labor. For if they fall, one will help his companion up. But pity the person who falls down and has no one to help him up. Oh, dear ones, when we, sinners and saints, liberals and conservatives, activists and pessimists, cautious and reckless, thinkers and doers, when we join together in love, we kick pain in the teeth. Let's do this thing. Amen. And now for some of the story behind the message. About a week ago, I had a really rough day. I was watching Facebook, as many of you do, quite a bit. I was seeing arguments and fights and people I love ripping apart people I love and doing it in the name of Jesus. My heart was broken. I felt like this was too hard. You know, this thing of being a peacemaker that Jesus calls us to be, of loving the unlovely, I just thought I'm ready to be done with it. I remember crying out to Jesus and just saying, "I don't know how to do this, and I really don't want to do this. I want to just be the activist that I am. I just want to keep going with doing the things I want to do. Jesus, I want to love you the best I can, but my heart is breaking because my friends are hurting and my friends are really saying some things that are cruel and mean, and it was just killing my heart. And I really wondered, you know, God, what are you going to do about this? You know, when we get in that space where we have fallen down and we don't know how to get back up, like we don't have the strength to do it on our own. I was in that space. I just felt like I didn't have the strength to do it on my own. I came upstairs and thought I'd just answer an email real quick. So opened up my computer and there was a video from my dear sweet friend, Abby. And Abby was singing a song that just spoke straight to me. It was like God said, "Hey, I hear you, and I've sent a friend to pick you up right now, because this thing of coming together is so much more important. It's so key to the issues at hand." And I just bawled, you guys. I broke. Like, my heart felt like it was just gonna fly out of my chest. The pain was heavy, and yet the love and the sweetness of God as she sang just overwhelmed me. And so I'm just gonna close this up in prayer again, and I will let you listen to Abby. So Holy Spirit, come, and I thank you that you are good. Father, I thank you that you are so good, that this whole thing right now feels like such a mess. And God, we want to stand up for those that are broken and hurt and cannot stand by themselves. We want to be able to lift people up, but we want to be able to love well, God, to take our eyes off of our issues and our thing and put our eyes straight on you, Jesus. And somehow in the mix of doing that, you cause people that are opposite and shouldn't be able to get along to come together and to bring your kingdom here. And so, Holy Spirit, I ask you to do it again. I ask you to bring healing to hearts, to those that are broken, to those that are crying, to those that are grieving because their friends, their family, even themselves, like they don't even know their own hearts anymore. They just don't even know. They feel so much pain. Father, bring healing so that we can go and lift up those who truly are in pain and who cannot get up on their own. God, may your kingdom come. Bring your kingdom here, God. Bring us together, God. Bring us together. In Jesus' name, amen.
Your heart be troubled. Hold your head up high.